Shoulder fills away, unchange my dead heart. Make me alive again, give me a fresh start. So change my heart, please, wash the filth away. Don't leave me drowning here, alone and astray. Don't leave me drowning here, alone and astray.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to another episode of The Power of Dhikr. In this episode, inshallah ta'ala, we're talking about certain circumstances or situations in which a Muslim should be remembering Allah Azza wa Jal. We've talked about the morning and the evening. We've talked about waking up and going to sleep. And inshallah, we're going to now talk about the wudu and the prayer. So before the wudu, what we do is we say Bismillah, and this is our first dhikr. After the wudu, one of the things we can say, and there are many things that are narrated to say after the wudu, but one of the things that we can say is Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika la, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. Allahumma ja'alni min at-tawwabin wa ja'alni min al-mutatahhirin. O Allah, I bear witness that there is no God worthy of worship except Allah, alone and with no partner. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his slave and his final messenger. O Allah, make me from those who repent and make me from those who purify themselves. This is a beautiful dua and it has a huge reward for it. That in this, that you say this thing and there is a huge, huge, huge reward in the sight of Allah Azza wa Jal for it. So make sure this is from the adhkar that you do on a regular basis. Now we look at the prayer, and there are various times for dhikr during the prayer. Of course, this is there is the recitation of the Qur'an, but even before the recitation of the Qur'an, there is dua al-istiftah, the dhikr that you say when you begin the prayer. So for example, from the adhkar that we say when we begin the prayer is the statement, Allahumma ba'id bayni wa bayna khatayaya kama ba'adta bayna al-mashriqi wal-maghrib. Allahumma naqini min al-khataya كما ينقى الثوب الأبيض من الدنس اللهم اغسلني من الخطايا أو من خطاياي بالثلج والماء والبرد. And this again, O Allah, distance me from my sins just as you have distanced the east from the west. O Allah, purify me of my sins as a white robe is purified of filth. O Allah, cleanse me of my sins with snow and with water and with ice. And there are, you know, of course, other du'as that we say, for example, Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdika wa tabarak ismuk ta'ala jadduk wa la ilaha ghayruk. How far from imperfections you are, O Allah. I praise you. Blessed is your name and lofty is your position, and none has the right to be worshipped except you. So these are things that we can say, and there are others that we can say before the prayer. So we're learning the dhikr that happens before we recite Surah Al-Fatiha after we've said Allahu Akbar. Then there is the time of ruku'. Of course, the standing is in recitation of the Qur'an, which is itself the best form of dhikr. Then you have the ruku'. And of course, everyone knows in the ruku', Subhana Rabbiyal Azeem, Subhana Rabbiyal Azeem, Subhana Rabbiyal Azeem. But there are other du'as in the ruku' other than Subhana Rabbiyal Azeem. Such as to say after Subhana Rabbiyal Azeem three times, to say Subhanak Allahumma Rabbana wa bihamdik, Allahumma ghfirli. To say Subhanak Allahumma, how far from imperfections you are. Tasbih, Subhanallah. Rabbana, our Lord. Wabi hamdik, and again Subhanallah wa bihamdi. So this is coming again in the ruku'. Allahumma ghfirli. This is again from the things that we can say in the ruku'. And there are others that we can say in the ruku' as well. So to make our ruku' longer, to make our ruku' more beloved to Allah, there are adhkar that we can learn for this. Upon rising from ruku', of course, we say, Rabbana wa laka alhamd, our Lord, and all praises to you. But we can add onto that after we say, Sami Allahu liman hamida, Rabbana wa laka alhamd, Allah listens to the one who praises him, our Lord, all praise is due to you. We can say, Hamdan, kathiran, tayyiban, mubarakan fi, a praise which is hamdan tayyiban, a praise which is tayyib, which is beautiful, which is good, which is kathiran, which is much, which is mubarak, which is mubarakan, which has barakah in it, is blessed. So we praise Allah Azza wa Jal, a praise, or the best form of praise, and a praise which is much, and a praise which is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and a praise which causes us to be blessed and is a blessed praise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these are things that we can say when we rise up from the ruku'. When we go into sujood, all of us know Subhana Rabbi al-A'la, Subhana Rabbi al-A'la, Subhana Rabbi al-A'la. Glory to be to my Lord, the Most High. But we can also add in other du'as after this. Again, we're trying to keep these in Arabic, depending obviously on the disagreement amongst the scholars, but especially in the Fard prayer, and indeed my advice is in all of the prayers, you stick to Arabic, and you learn these for yourself. So for example, from the du'as that the Prophet ﷺ used to say in his sujood, after he said, Subhana Rabbi al-A'la, he used to say, Ya Muqallib al-Qulub, Thabbit Qalbi ala Deenik. O Turner of the Hearts, turn my heart upon your religion. From the du'as that he used to say, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in sajda, is Allahumma inni a'udhu bi ridaaka min sakhatik, wa bi mu'afatika min uqubatik, wa a'udhu bika mink, la uhsi thana'an alayk, anta kama athnayta ala nafsik. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, O Allah, I seek refuge with your pleasure from your anger, and with your pardon from your punishment, and with you from you. And I cannot enumerate your praise. I can't be able to praise you in the way that you deserve. You are as you have praised yourself. And this is the difference between Allah Azza wa Jalla and everything that is worshipped besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that everything else you run away from to Allah. And when you wish to run away from the punishment of Allah, you run to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in everything else, you run away from that which you're scared of. With being scared of Allah, you run to Allah, not away from Him. So you seek refuge with Allah, from Allah, because you seek refuge with His pleasure from His punishment, with His anger from, or with His pardon from His anger, and you seek refuge with Allah from Allah Azza wa Jalla. Because there's nobody that can save you from the punishment of Allah except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there's nothing that can save you from the anger of Allah except His pleasure. And so on and so forth. Between the two prostrations, there are du'as and dhikr that you can make. Rabbi ghfirli is from the things that you can say in between. You can also say, Allahumma ghfirli, warhamni, wahdini, wa'afini, warzuqni. O Allah, forgive me and have mercy on me and guide me and give me health and grant me sustenance. These are from the things that you can say in between the two sajdas. So this is all about lengthening your prayer, making more khushu in your prayer, making your prayer closer to that which Allah Azza wa Jal is pleased with. From the du'as that you can make in the prayer is that which you make after the tashahud. So we all know the du'a that, O Allah, I seek refuge with you from the punishment of the grave and from the punishment of the hellfire and from the trials of being of life and death and from the trials of the Masih al-Dajjal. We all make this du'a in its many different forms. But after that, there are other adhkar that you can make. Again and again. So it's about learning all of these different adhkar in their different places and their different positions. So lengthening your prayer, more khushu in your prayer. Now we come to the topic of after the prayer. And just before we talk about after the prayer, let's just skip back a moment to before the prayer and just make sure that everybody knows that there is no niyyah that you say aloud for the prayer. There's no dhikr to establish the niyyah for the prayer. But the niyyah for the prayer, it means that if somebody stops you and says to you, what are you doing? You say, I'm praying dhuhr. That's your niyyah. Somebody stops you and says, what are you doing? You say, I'm praying maghrib. How many rak'ah is it? Three. That's your niyyah. The fact that you know what you're doing, but if you were to be stood there praying, let's say, maghrib, and you have in your heart that you don't know what you're doing, or you can't remember what you're doing, or you're sort of stood there and you have no idea how you came there, you're sleepwalking, then this is not the right niyyah. But niyyah is where somebody stops you and asks you, what you were doing, you would be able to answer. It doesn't have a verbal form. It's not like, oh Allah, I'm praying these two rak'ah behind this imam in this masjid, and I'm going to read in the first one, and then I'm going to do ruku, and then I'm going. It's not like this. Your niyyah is something that is in your heart, and you need it before wudu, you need it before the prayer. Jumping back now towards the end of the prayer. The end of the prayer, after the salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah, salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah, you have a fantastic opportunity for adhkar. You have these beautiful adhkar after the prayer. from the beautiful adhkar after the prayer is to say Subhanallah 33 times, counting on your right hand, not counting on your left hand, not counting on rosary beads or tickers, but counting on your right hand using the marks, using the marks on your thumbs and your fingers to count. Subhanallah, Subhanallah, Subhanallah. You go around once, then again, that's 15. Then Subhanallah, Subhanallah, Subhanallah. You go around again, that's 30. And then Subhanallah, 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 that's 33. And likewise, Alhamdulillah, and likewise, Allahu Akbar. And they are from the most beloved of the words to Allah Azza wa Jal. There's also a narration for doing them 10 times each. So you should balance between them, and you should do it 33. And then every now and again, you can do it 10 times as well. So there's those things. There are those things that we say, for example, after the prayer, immediately we say, Astaghfirullah, 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 Allahumma, Anta as-salam wa minka as-salam tabarakta ya dhal jalali wal ikram. We say that, O Allah, we say, forgive me, O Allah, forgive me, O Allah, forgive me. O Allah, you are as-salam. From you comes all safety and security. And so you are as-salam. You are the cause of us being protected and the cause of us being saved. And you are the source of our safety and security. And from you comes salam. From you comes the safety and security that we have, the peace and safety and tranquility that we have. It comes from you. Tabarakta, blessed are you. Ya dhal jalali wal ikram. Allah Azza wa Jalla is the owner of majesty and honor, the one who all majesty and honor is attributed to him. And if anyone else has any degree of majesty or any degree of honor, it is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given it to them. And then of course, we read Ayatul Kursi. And Ayatul Kursi, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the one who reads it after the prayer, there is nothing between him and paradise except death. The only thing stopping you between paradise and between you and paradise is for you just simply to die. And all you have to do is to read Ayatul Kursi after every single prayer, Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum, to the end, wa huwa al-aliyyul azim, to the end of the ayah, 255 in Surah Al-Baqarah. So you read this ayah as well. You read Qul huwa Allahu ahad, you read Qul a'udhu bi rabbil falaq, Qul a'udhu bi rabbin nas, and there are some other simple du'as like Allahumma a'inni ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadatik, or Allah, give me the ability to remember you, to do your dhikr, give me the ability to thank you, and help me to thank you, and help me to perform your worship in the best possible way. So these are some of the adhkar, not all of them, but some of them that you can do after the salah. So we see right from the wudu all the way to the end of the prayer, there are plenty of adhkar that you can learn, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to teach us what benefits us and to benefit us with what teaches us, with what He teaches us, and to give us the ability to implement what He teaches us and to make what we know a proof for us, not against us. Please do join us in the next episode of The Power of Dhikr, where we'll be looking at another place and another time for dhikr in the life of a Muslim. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Make me alive again. Give me a fresh start. So change my heart, please. Wash the filth away. Don't leave me drowning here, alone and astray. Don't leave me drowning here, alone and astray.